From Viking halls to the cities of the future, terrain buffs will love our foreground hub. Watch gaming tables of all genres come to life at beastofwar.com. Become a general of mighty armies at the Kings of War Hub. Take command of elves, dwarves, and orcs in this game of masked fantasy combat on beastofwar.com.
Hey everybody. So, at Gen Con, Fantasy Flight's Mansion of Madness 2nd Edition was the total talk of the town, and I couldn't pass up the opportunity to get in on it. So, had to snag a copy for myself, and I thought, who would be fun to play this game? And then I thought there would be no one else other than Vicky and John, because any excuse to dress as your character is a great excuse. Not that any excuse is ever really needed. So, first, I'm going to tell you a little bit about our characters.
I'm William York, Shakespearean actor turned grave digger. Whenever a monster is defeated, I gain one clue.
I am Wendy Adams, a poor street urchin who is searching for her parents, and all she has to remember them by is the amulet that her mother gave her. I cannot become stunned or restrained during the game.
And I am Agatha Crane, a rather eccentric older lady who is a parapsychologist and wondering what all of this shenanigans is about. When we are resolving a horror check, I get a clue. So, from the perspective of what the overarching premise of this game is, it's inspired by H.P. Lovecraft. We are literally dropped into the Mansion of Madness. We're going to play an app scenario shortly for you here, so you'll have an idea of what we're trying to accomplish as far as the scene is set. But for now, we've populated just the initial two tiles of the mansion. The great thing about this game is that it is driven by the app, and it is truly a game where the app makes sense, because the app controls the bad guys and all the madness in the mansion. But we still get to interact with the board and the pieces out here. We'll still get to move our miniatures each turn. And as things are indicated on the board, the red lanterns are rooms that have yet to be explored, and you don't know what's on the other side of the door until the app tells you which tile to populate. Question marks are items that need to be investigated within a room. Some of these objects are barricades that you can push around on the board. This little symbol is actually an area telling you that that is not a door that needs to be opened, but once a character moves into that space, the next area will be visible there, and again, the app will tell us what that is. So we are truly at the mercy of what the app tells us to do, so let's play.
You slump into your office chair after another long day of interviews. You've been investigating the disappearances surrounding a wealthy neighborhood for 2 weeks, but you have nothing to show for it. The telephone rings. You answer and hear the panicked voice of an older man.
Is this the investigator who visited the Vanderbilt estate?
You flip through the files on your desk. William Vanderbilt, a wealthy bachelor, mother recently deceased. He has refused to meet with you, but you are able to speak to several members of his serving staff.
This is Eugene, Mr. Vanderbilt's butler, right? I didn't know who else to call. The police think I'm crazy. Unnatural things have started happening here. I'm worried for my master. I think he's in danger. Please, help.
Finally, a lead. You hang up the phone, throw on your coat, and leave for the Vanderbilt estate.
All right, so we have arrived at the entrance of the Vanderbilt Manor. This is a cooperative game, and we do need to work together and try to figure out what's going on. The scary thing about this game is that you truly do not know what your end game is until you're into the play for a little while and you start stumbling on things that'll kind of give us an indication of what we're trying to do. So for now, we just go and explore. So who wants to get us started?
Oh, I'll go first.
All right. Wendy, take us away.
All right.
What would you like to do?
I would like to find out what this is over here.
All right, so we're going to investigate. A disheveled pile of papers sits on a table. The papers stacked on the table are invitations marked with today's date. Stars have come round to their positions in the cycle of eternity.
The Vanderbilt Astronomy Association cordially invites you to a celebratory evening. Gain one clue and then discard the search token. So in this game, clues can be used and spent later in the game to buy you extra actions. When you get into solving the meat of puzzles and things, that's especially useful. So we have explored this item and that is out of the way. And we each get two actions each turn. So that was one. What else would you like to do?
I will move into the next section.
All right. And that is it for you. William, would you like to go?
All right. Well, I will move forward. And I think I will check out what that is.
All right. A mysterious painting of landscape is under a night sky, overlooks a lavish entryway. Shadowy figures can be seen amidst the landscape. However, something in the stars catches your interest. This requires a lore value to be entered. So what is your lore value?
3.
So you get to roll 3 dice, and we will see what your end result is.
1. Not very good.
The star symbols in this game are successes. The clues kind of are nothing until later if indicated, and the blanks are obviously nothing at all. So you have a whopping 1. So we will enter your 1 and confirm.
It's a painting.
Your recollection of the constellations is hazy, but something about the painting rubs you the wrong way. There must be a detail you're missing. AKA try harder next time.
Yeah.
What else would you like to do?
That was actually, I moved.
Oh, you moved and did. All right, so it's my turn. Do I want to move up by you guys and look at the painting? Do we want to go in a room?
I'm going to guess you couldn't have a worse eye for paintings than I do.
Yeah, let's have a look. She's pretty smart. She's been around the block for a little while. All right, so I'm moving up and I'm going to take a whack at this painting. So, again, it requires my lore value. Can I have my character card? Oh, never mind.
Yes.
Were a snake, it would have bit me. All right, so my lore value is 5. So I get all 5 dice.
Whoop.
She's way smarter than you.
I know, right? A little bit.
She can still roll.
Oh, but I rolled the same thing he rolled, which is really unfortunate. So I'm going to
guess. All that schooling for nothing.
It still looks like a painting. You identify several specks of light in the sky as planets. They're occupying the same section of the sky, as if coming together in alignment. Not unlike the planets in the sky tonight. Beneath the painting reads a plaque. In memory of Lilith Vanderbilt, gain 2 clues and then discard this token. So 1 was more effective than your 1. So
wow.
With age comes wisdom, apparently. So 2 clues for me. And that was our turns. So there's an investigator phase and then a mythos phase, and that's where we're going to head now. So lights flicker, and for an instant, shadows that were cast by nothing on this earth stalk across the wall.
No immediate effect.
So, nice. Kind of a scary moment. There was probably creepy music. And we're back to the investigator phase. So, what would we like to do next?
I am going to go check out what's going on over here.
Okay. Well, we're taking a look in a room. So, there is a door that leads to a small front room of the mansion. The light from the entry shines into the dimly lit office as you open the door. A lamp sits on a large wooden desk, casting long shadows across a mess of papers and books scattered around the room. Place the study tile as indicated and then discard the explorer tokens leading to it. So as you can see, it actually tells you which tile to find. So John's going to be our tile master. And so the desktop under the lamp is cluttered with papers. Place a search token there. There's something to look at. And across the room, a bookcase stacked with books and other items stands against one wall. Among the items, you spot something useful. Place the medical textbook common item as indicated. An investigator can pick up this item in the space as part of a trade action. And then there is another door across the room. So we put the door token there. You may move 1 space into the explored area. I'm guessing you want to explore whatever that is, Wendy.
I need to know.
All right, inquiring minds want to know. The desk is covered with random clutter, from a small space cleared at the front of a chair for you to start working. You dig through the dense paperwork cluttering the desk looking for anything of interest.
So this requires you to use your observation value.
And I have four of those.
Four of those. So roll up four and see how much you find.
Ooh, three.
She killed us there. Look at that. Three.
I'm just saying.
Show off.
I have a magic amulet.
Yeah, clearly.
You get to go into every room first now.
As you shuffle through the seemingly endless paperwork covering the desk, you spot a weathered journal that looks out of place amidst the mundane clutter. The cover of the journal is marked Lilith Vanderbilt. Gain the old journal unique item and discard the search token. The investigator holding the old journal can read through its entries by interacting with it on the app.
You got reading material for your next turn. Old journal.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And that is gone now.
All right.
What shall we do?
Come on in here.
Yeah,
really
I better
nice.
Go in there.
Are we going to do safety in numbers? Yeah. Is that going to be our overarching theme?
Seems like the we'll best go with plan. It. I'm gonna. What is the other thing that is a? Oh, the medical journal.
Yeah.
I guess I'm. I mean, I gotta wait.
William's
for you anyway.
Not impressed.
I gotta wait.
He's
for
like,
you.
Yeah. Fend for yourself, child.
I know, right?
Painting book. Yeah. That's what I'm thinking.
Okay.
Thinking.
All right. So your movement was one, and then would you like to pick up that?
Yeah,
book?
I would like to take okay. the book. I don't know what
one
I'm
book
do with
for
it.
You, and that Excellent. Leaves me. And I think I'm going to just follow you guys. So I'm going to move. And you can move up to two spaces. So I'm going to go one and two. And shall I take a look
I
in the next room? Let's see what there is. A door leads deeper into the mansion. Thank you, Captain Obvious. A hall continues from the bathroom hall towards the side of the mansion. Place the hall end tile as indicated, and discard all explore or sight tokens leading to it. And someone acting in a hurry has knocked over a stack of papers. Place a search token as indicated. So there's papers all over the floor in there. Two doors lead to other rooms in the mansion. Place the explore tokens as indicated. So there's one. Oh, and that's the other one. All right. You may move one space into the explored area. And that is my turn, which unfortunately puts us back to the mythos phase. Yes, we're going to end the investigator phase. Oh, boy. Darkness falls. Inky blackness envelops Agatha Crane. Oh, great.
No, Agatha.
Bringing it with a soft, gentle... Susurrus? Suffus? What is that word? Place darkness in each space in Agatha Crane's room, and she suffers one face-down horror. Willpower does negate it. So, this will be darkness. And I get one face down. Whoops, I get to roll. What is my willpower?
Sorry, is that,
four.
Is that Thank my you. Hair? That's...
Probably. Jeez, William.
William. Stop shedding on the board, please.
My willpower of four. And I actually did roll successes. And so each one of success would cancel one whore or one wound. So in this case, I do not suffer anything, which is cool. Is that the only thing that happens? Of course it's not. You hear a blood-curdling scream and the sound of tearing flesh from another room. And then silence. You have a feeling that you were too late to save the butler, and each investigator suffers two horror. Aw, oh, really?
Man.
I didn't even know the guy.
I know, right? Bummer. Okay, so here we go.
Thank you.
That's unfortunate. A creature bursts into the lobby from the direction of the scream. If the door is blocked by barricades, discard that barricade. It's not, because we didn't think to move it. A creature's black serpentine body shifts and changes, playing tricks on your eye as you try to focus on it. A creature unfurls its leathery wings and unleashes a blood-curdling screech. Spawn a hunting horror as indicated. Fabulous. Don't make him move up any closer than he already is. Things will get bad enough.
You can see
really
you
fast.
If he was up there.
The hunting horror moves three spaces towards the investigator within range with the lowest strength and then attacks that investigator.
He's heading for you.
Oh, no, he's heading for you.
That's you.
Oh, Wendy.
All right. So it attacks the investigator. So it attacks. The creature grabs you with its claws, attempting to drag you away. So you are going to test against this with your agility.
Oh, good.
You need to roll agility of 2. If you pass, you hold your ground and bat the beast away. If you fail, the beast's claws sink in and tear your flesh as you're carried away and suffer 2 damage. So you gotta
try to beat that. My youth and my years of living on the street as an urchin have made me very agile. I get 5. Oh my gosh.
Oh, no.
I still kick my fanny.
And yes, that's what happens when you talk like that.
Trash talking gets you nowhere. Nowhere in this game.
Oh, we're so confident.
You suffer 2 damage, and then you and the creature move 1 space away from the study. Oh, it's moving you away from us, too.
Oh,
so much for our safety in numbers.
No,
so
creature.
You get
better you than me.
2 damage.
Thanks a lot, William.
So
you're big help with your shovel.
Core and damage cards. You acquire a quantity of them before you suffer like the full effects of them. So it's 8 wounds. Is it 6 and 8?
I have 6
oh,
and 8.
Oh, it's yeah, wounds is however many wounds that you suffer. I have 5. And then whore is also a separate number on your card. And after you accumulate those many cards, you discard the lot of them and you take a condition card that sticks with you. So you have to cycle through either of those instances 2 times to be dead or out of the game. So, but meanwhile, poor Wendy is getting dragged
out here. That's really a bummer. I suppose you'll be expecting us to come after you.
Be nice. Don't leave the small child to be eaten by it.
Now, each investigator must resolve a horror check against the monster within range of the highest horror rating.
As we only get 1.
Yeah, so his
is
awareness
he in range, though?
His awareness is 5. So that's a bummer. Yes, he is in range for all of us. So we each get to roll against this. So we have to select the monster. Resolve a horror check. The creature begins to clean itself though clean is a generous term. It runs its claws over itself, scraping off gunks of dry blood and blistered flesh, probably belonging to Wendy. Suffer 2 horror. Willpower negates it. If you suffer 1 or more horror, the sight and smell make you nauseous and you become dazed.
So we each need to roll our willpower to see if we can fend
this. Is it
this
minus
up.
1?
Willpower minus 1.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
I'm rolling 2. I got 1. How many negates it?
It says willpower minus 1. So you actually got to roll 2, suffer 2 horror. So you avoided 1.
Oh, alrighty. Thank you.
And I have a willpower of 3. 4. So I get to roll 3. And I take both, which really stinks. Sorry.
I also have 3. I'm going to take 2 different dice because hopefully they'll roll a little better.
Right?
Nope. I get 1.
Well, this might be like a super short game. We're just trying to make it interesting for you and show you what happens when bad things happen. And that was finally that disastrous mythos phase. And it is back to our turn. So I'm assuming we're going to have to try to help Wendy and take care of whatever that is.
Wendy's always in trouble.
Bring it on, people.
Well, I don't know. You said you're so tough and everything, but...
Well, is it my turn now? Because
it could be whoever's turn.
Yeah, we
so.
Can go in whatever order.
Oh, that's right. Well, I'll go and I'm going to attack the monster.
Okay.
With a weapon.
All right.
Have a shotgun.
So.
But that's right. It can't be too far away.
Right. It has to
be close.
With me.
So we are going to attack the monster, and that is a firearm. A creature momentarily turns away from you, and you take the opportunity to fire. So you will be rolling your agility.
Oh, lucky.
And it's agility of 2 if to pass it. And
I
she
got
does.
2.
She does. If you pass, you seem to surprise the beast, and it unleashes a terrible noise. The monster suffers damage equal to the weapon's damage, which is
6.
Brutal. So this guy is he takes exactly 6.
Wow.
Wow, one shot Wendy.
That's
win.
Right. That's our living on the street.
There's our W's. Yeah. So are you sure you want to discard the hunting horse? Yes, we are. Because that is how Wendy likes to do it.
That's how I roll.
That's what you get for dragging her out of the room.
That's right. Now I'm going back in the room. I just left.
All right. And that is so your turn.
Monster.
Do you want to be right there or do you want to move up a sec? Because you can move up to 2 spaces.
Oh, I'll move 2 then.
Okay. All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So who would like to go next?
I will jump into the next room, I guess.
Maybe.
Or do you want to go first?
Why don't
you go
first? Just in case something bad happens and then you can fight it.
That's true. Yep.
So just saying. Not that I'm scared.
You're right.
I am a little bit. But yeah. Okay. So a stack of papers has been strewn about on the floor. Amidst the mundane paperwork, you find a weathered page covered in strange script. Someone has scrawled in a note in English across the top of the page. Speak these words for great power. What could possibly happen? Should I speak the words?
Do it. Speak
right.
The words.
I'm going to recite the script. The eldritch words seem to take on a life of their own as you speak them, reshaping your mind with new understanding of the script you are looking at. The lights flicker and you hear a whisper in your ear. Power comes with a price. Gain the wither spell and then discard the search token. Ooh, I just got a spell. Which says, when the spell takes effect, the victim's body withers and mummifies.
Nice.
That might be handy.
She's halfway there already.
No. Hey, listen. Who picked up the journal? Did you pick up the journal or did you pick up the journal?
She's got the journal. I have the medical textbook.
Yes, I did.
All right, so you're going to have to read at some point.
Oh, I forgot about reading.
What else do I need? Well, you were a little preoccupied
so
with creepy slithering monsters.
Being an awesome
dragged
shotgun
off
master.
And yeah. Yeah, well, that too.
Monster slayer there.
Do I want to open another room? Oh, yeah, and there's darkness over there, which I don't remember what that does, but right now there's something bad in the room, so.
I say plunge on forward. Do it.
Should I do this room? Yeah, otherwise I would have to move first.
Yeah.
All right. A weathered door stands at the end of the hall. You hear bizarre noises from the other side. When you try the handle, you find the door is locked. A keyhole sits beneath the brass door handle. Well, that sounded like an epic fail. So, that was me. William, what would you like to do on your turn?
Well, I guess I will go into the other room and check out the other room.
All right.
I gotta see which one I am.
I'm gonna move up two and then see what this is. You suspect the unmarked door leads to a bedroom. Can't get anything past you, William.
Yeah, I know. I don't know how you suspected that.
The door opens into a bedroom that seems modest compared to the door in the rest of the mansion. Discard this token and replace with bedroom 2 tile as indicated. All right. Near the door, a small writing desk holds an immense book. Place the search token as indicated. And in the far corner, a large chest sits next to the master bed. Place a search token as indicated. All right. You may move one space into that explored area. And it says you may. You never have to move if it says may.
I feel okay.
Okay.
You know, we're in three different rooms now.
Ish.
I don't feel great.
I know, right?
I feel okay.
All right.
Wendy, you still in range?
Yeah, Wendy.
Oh, now you're all worried about where Wendy's at. Before a monster sucked her out of her room.
Now we enter the mythos phase.
Oh, now I'm
what could possibly go wrong? Oh, Wendy Adams squints against the weakest light, and the pain in her head throbs in time with her heartbeat. So, strength of 1. You need to try to pass a strength test.
Okay.
See if you succumb to the headache.
I have strength of 3.
Come on, Wendy.
You just need 1. Oh,
yay!
Kills it with 2. If she passes, the headache is just a distraction to work through. If she fails, she clutches her head. Okay, well, you didn't fail, so that's a good thing. And now, you will pay for the price of that power. The lights flicker and the air crackles with electricity. Suddenly, reality seems to split before you, and a terrifying creature slips from an unknowable space beyond. Spawn a deep one, as indicated.
Dang it. Where is he spawning it? Over. Oh, right next to you, Agatha.
Yep. Dang. Oh, me and the creatures, man. Okay. Deep one moves 2 spaces towards the nearest investigator, or nowhere because it's right next to the investigator, and then it attacks the investigator with the lowest agility, which I'm there. So, lashing out with its webbed feet, the deep one tries to sweep your legs from beneath you. So, I need to roll agility of 2. And I only have agility of 3. I can do it.
You can do it. You're a very nimble lady.
It's just like double dutch.
Right. It's been a while since I've double dutched.
failed miserably. So
I suffered 2 whore. That's really not good. I take 9 and I'm sitting at 6. Mm.
Each investigator must now resolve a horror check against the monster within range of the highest horror rating, which is this guy. And he is an awareness of 3, so we unfortunately are all. So let's do the horror check.
So we click on the monster.
I know. But see, we're sharing it equally. Like, no matter what, we all suffer the same thing. A thick, fishy aroma fills the air as the deep one exhales hideous fumes. So a willpower of 2 is what we need to roll to succeed and not suffer. How much willpower do you have, Wendy?
Wendy has a 3.
I have 4. Come on, 2 successes. 1 success. Really? Mm. So I suffer 1. What am I doing?
It's not looking good.
Did you pass any?
None.
None? Oh, man.
Thank you.
1. Y'all smell like fish now.
I know, right? Mm. What is that smell? Okay. So, that was the end of that. Yes, that's the end of the mythos phase. Back to us. Now we gotta take care of this guy.
I have a 45 automatic. Should I try it?
Let's most librarians
pull
do.
It, dirty grandma.
Well, you know, there's a little known story, you know, about me. I can't talk about it, or I will have to shoot you or myself. It really just kind of depends on how I'm wielding the weapon.
They're really serious about being quiet in the library.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah. You don't want to cross, you know.
Do not bring back a book late.
No. Yeah. No.
Things getting real.
All right. So I'm going to attack with a firearm. You take aim at the figure's legs, hoping to slow down its advance. I have to roll my agility.
And an agility of 2, and I only have an agility. Really? Every time you do this when you have a weapon, by the way, it's never the same thing twice, so you can't assume that because you have to roll 1 stat against it at a point that it's going to work that way next time. You know, like for me, for instance, it would be really awesome if I was not rolling with my agility, although my strength is terrible too. And I possibly shot myself. So if you fail, quick footwork on your enemy's part allows it to remain unharmed. Oh, I didn't hurt myself. That's kind of a miracle. Do I dare try it again is the question.
Fire wildly at it.
I might as well, because otherwise if I try to evade, that won't be good.
You could try to make the monster some soup.
I'm not that kind of grandma, okay? I don't do the soup, and he doesn't look like he'd like it anyway. Maybe fish soup. I don't know. The gun roars and shakes in your hands, again with the agility.
Oh, man.
It's better than my strength, though. I suppose I shouldn't complain. Come on.
Maybe a 22 would have done grandma better.
I think it would have.
Oh. Nope. Only 1. If you fail, the recoil knocks your aim off. Oh, at least not my head. So I suppose I got that going for me. All right.
Well, that was my ineffective turn.
At least you drew everybody's attention.
I know, right? Hey, look over here.
Go on, William. You haven't attacked nothing yet. Let's see what you got.
I mean, the one-shot Wendy doesn't want to take it out.
I want to let everyone have the opportunity. We watch Agatha spin in circles, firing a gun into the air blindly.
Agatha quite possibly escaped from a nursing home, okay? She probably shouldn't have had the firearm in the first place.
Okay. I'm going to go fight him with my brass knuckles.
All right. I'll see what
Come
you got.
Come on. Get it, William.
What am I?
So you are going to hopefully attack with something helpful.
Strength, I hope.
And that is considered, is that unarmed?
It's unarmed,
technically?
Yeah.
You unleash a fury of quick punches, hoping enough of them will hit and make a difference. So agility of 2 you need.
All right, and I have 3 agility, and for the brass knuckles, I get 2 extra dice.
Well, so that works.
I've got
that
5
totally
dice.
Works. Come on, you can roll 2.
Not 5
Surely
nothings.
You can roll 2.
Stop calling me Shirley. Oh.
Oh, my goodness.
This has got to be the world's worst dice rolling.
I might have
rolling.
Punched myself.
So if you fail, your enemy blocks come more quickly than you expect. At least you didn't hurt yourself. Would I thought like he was to sleeping. Try that again.
Do it again. It was fun to watch.
Hell of a joke. Maybe that'll
work. Another, even though I had to move to get in there?
Oh.
Wasn't that one of my moves?
Nope.
That I think it was a complete failure on my part.
That was an utter failure. All right. Wendy, one shot.
I'm going to take my one shot because I can shoot my shotgun from the other room. Stand
yes,
back.
Please. We probably really should have started with that.
I wanted to let everyone try.
Wendy likes to toy with people is what this amounts to. You take aim at the figure's legs, hoping to slow its advance. Your agility, you need agility of two.
You're so lucky.
And I got a five.
Ooh. And she does
man.
It again.
You shot
one
both
shot.
His legs.
One shot.
Yeah, you attack first next time.
I know, right?
Hey, stop making
I don't
us
listen
look
to her
bad.
Anymore.
You just remember, next time something dragged me out of room, you come right away and save me.
She can look at all the paintings. You can kill everything. And I've got a shovel.
So you deal weapon equal to the weapon's damage. So six.
That is really
kill
nice.
It?
Yes,
that.
You totally killed it.
Oh, man, I'm blowing monster. These things out of the water.
Crazy. And you still have a move left.
Oh.
One shot.
I'm
going to
go
that
in
on
and
one
you know what? And
I'm
I forgot the last time,
William.
But I need to get a thing for we defeated a monster.
Yes,
I
we did. And now one. You we defeated another monster.
Are we going to give me the last
You're
one?
You're welcome.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you. Thanks for killing everything, Wendy.
Yeah, right.
And I will, let's see, come into this room.
Oh, look what I just did.
Yeah. Well, at least we're all together now, so mm-hmm. if something bad happens, it'll probably happen to all of us instead of... I'm not sure if that's good or not. We'll see. All right. An invisible presence passes close by Agatha Crane, hurling her painfully to the ground. Agatha Crane suffers 2 face-down damage. Oh, that's the only damage I've taken so far,
that's
though.
That's good.
So, all
the
right.
invisible presence is arthritis.
It's real, okay? And it hurts. Let's not make jokes. A robed figure appears from a secret door and begins searching around. Upon seeing signs of other people, the figure yells, "There's someone here!" And you hear a muffled response from another part of the estate. "Get rid of them!" And spawn a cultist as indicated. So now there's a cultist in the lobby. Cultist, please report to the lobby. The cultist moves 2 spaces toward the nearest investigator, and it attacks the investigator with the lowest strength. But the good news is 2 is not going to get him to us. So for a change, that worked. No investigators
it's
in
It's nice
space.
That they heard us after 2 shotgun blasts and 2 shots of the 45.
It takes that
like,
much.
There's somebody here.
Yeah, they're very perceptive. Yes. Each investigator must resolve a horror check against the monster within range of the highest horror rating. I betcha he, well, what is his, he is awareness of 3. All right, so we do have to roll horror checks against that. Yes, we need to resolve a horror check. The cultist laughs a deep, loyous laugh, and the sound echoes all around you. So willpower. You just need willpower 1 to pass. He's not that tough, which is good. Oh. Although I say that, and I bet I could possibly not roll a single success.
I just rolled 5 no successes, so.
And, I finally did. I succeeded.
Hooray.
Yay, because I'm, like, ever so close to being mad.
I get 3.
One. All right, come on, William.
I'm
going
to take all these ones with the stars up.
There you go, oops. The lucky ones.
Yeah. Maybe one shot just has to touch him first. One by the skin of his teeth. So we succeed, and nothing bad happens there, so that's a good thing. Back to our phase. So, are we going to try to deal with this guy? One shot? Are you going to try to take this
please,
guy out?
All right,
before something
all right.
bad happens?
I have to move 1 in here, and then I'm going to shoot him.
This is the All About One Shot Wendy episode, apparently.
That's
so
right.
Nobody else is going to do anything of interest. So, all right. So you're going to take a shoot at our friend here. Attack with the firearm. It is so much easier to shoot the enemy from a comfortable distance than to engage in unseemly fisticuffs. So your agility of 2.
And I get 5 for my agility. And
all right. And she, there she is again.
Kapow.
Is only
I'm just
going to
hang on your back the whole time.
I know, right? We're in the back. We just cheer. We're like, so, Wendy.
The moral of this story is get yourself a street urchin. Ever
right.
got to go somewhere
Who
scary.
Now you know the tactics. All right. So he is toast. And guess what, William?
Oh, yeah. Sweet. Thank you.
Get a clue, William.
Yeah, I know.
And what else would you like to do?
I think that's it because I moved into
you
the
moved.
Room and I
okay.
shot him.
All right.
Well, that's not enough for you?
I know,
killed
right?
another one?
oh, shoot, and we made you do that, and so you can't read. Oh, well. Eventually we have to make
it. I gotta read, I gotta
We all could
things.
Have been hurt, so
that's true. That's
I'm
true.
Happy
Thank
it's
you for
dead.
Saving us, Wendy.
Again.
I'm gonna move up and look at whatever that is in
Good
the
deal.
Corner. This book over here. Does that work?
Mm-hmm.
I like
that
one,
plan.
Two. All right. A modest writing desk sits in the corner of the bedroom, holding a massive tome that almost covers the desk's entire surface. Fortunately, I have my reading glasses on, so. Mm-hmm. You pull a creaking wooden chair up to the desk and attempt to decipher the archaic scribblings on the tome's pages, which uses my lore value, which is 5. So please roll something useful for a change. It's not fighting, so maybe.
You can do it.
2. That's not terrible. At least it wasn't none. As you slowly piece together the script, it reveals the directions to some vile ritual meant to summon beings from realms beyond reality, as well as instructions on the magic to contain them. Gain the arcane manuscript common item, and then discard the search token. All right. And that is my turn. So, William, if you would like to go while I am digging for...
And I can't get over to that
arcane
other clue.
Manuscript. Got it.
But I don't want to run away and check another room yet, so...
Okay.
I think you should wait there, because that door has a lock on it, and I'm going to say I can get in there and check that clue, and then you'd be by the door.
Oh, that's true.
Or I can, and you can stay where you are with your ever-so-useful weapon.
There you go, boom, that is true.
Since we are so utterly ineffective against...
Okay. What,
yeah, I'm going to throw some papers off the floor, maybe a paper cut, you know. So, I don't know. What do you think? William, what would you like to do?
Does anyone have too much of the...
2, 4, 6, 7 I have.
7, so you got a little ways to go. Okay, because I have the holy water at some point if... Someone needs to trade for it, and since I'm not doing anything, does anyone want that? Is anyone super
scared
they're about to go crazy?
Well, you better give it to her, because she's about to go nuts. And if she goes nuts, then, we only know what Agatha's
going to
be running around here doing.
So the next turn, I can do that, because I can't use it now. I have to use it as an action, right? Because that's a trade action. So do you want something of mine, or...
Is there anything good that'll help me?
Can you aim better with a 45?
Roll an extra die while resolving a lore test. I have a spell to remove.
You can keep everything.
Somebody. All right. Yeah. All right.
Pretty happy with my brass knuckles, even though I can't hit anything.
Do you want to do anything else, or is that, are you content?
I think that's it. I think I'll just sit right there. Is that a barricade?
No, that is darkness, but we don't have a light source to do anything with it. Okay. Wait, do you have a lantern?
I have a kerosene lantern.
Oh, yeah, you do.
It says that I may discard this card to convert all of my clues to stars while attacking unarmed. So it's
there you go.
Your arm, though.
Yeah,
I know.
You should give that to me, because I'm the only unarmed
here. You can't. You have to wait till your turn to do a trade. Unless you want to.
Can he trade?
Could I do that too?
Sure, why not?
Because I traded you.
Yes.
That's one move, and we'll trade you one. Okay.
Sure.
I'll take it.
What you giving me?
Nothing. You get nothing.
I'm not liking this trade. Somehow feel I just got robbed, not traded.
Right.
Maybe your shotgun wants to say something about it.
All right, and now we are back to the mythos phase. Yes, we want to end the investigator's phase. A cacophony of creaks and knocks erupts all around you. This mythos event affects the investigator with the lowest lore. I have a lore of 5.
3.
Rock, paper, scissors?
Lore off. It's a lore off.
Yeah, it's a lore off.
How much damage do you have? You got 4 crazies and no damage. I think you should man up there.
Okay.
I think, yeah,
I'll take it.
That sounds
what am
all
I
right.
Getting?
We're not sure. I'll tell you in a minute.
Mystery.
The sound is unnerving, and you fear what could be causing it. So your willpower. You need willpower of 2 to pass. How smart are you over there, William?
I have 3 lore.
That's not terrible.
It's not great.
We've seen dumber.
I'm sorry. This is willpower.
Yes.
I have 4 willpower.
Oh.
Oh my goodness.
I'm going to go dig my own grave real quick.
You are a dopey dope.
If you fail, the noise becomes panicked voices, as if there were madmen just out of sight. Suffer one horror and then flip one horror face up.
Uh-oh.
So this and flip it, this one face
it
up?
It says flip any off. Of them. You can, if that one doesn't feel lucky, no, you can't look at
that. I was like,
but you could randomly pick one of your other ones.
I'll just take this one.
And so what is
it? Oh, look at that. Claustrophobia. It's too close in here, too tight. You cannot breathe. You must get to open air. Whenever you end your turn within range of two or fewer spaces, suffer one face down horror. Whenever you end your turn within range of two or fewer spaces of what?
I think two or fewer. People? Oh, like corners. You need to...
Well, I would always be near a corner.
Well, no, but like, because this is... Like, if you were in this room, there's no door over here, and there's only one space that you can move to over here, so you'd be claustrophobic. Where, like, if you were over here, and there's multiple areas that you could head, directions you could head in, you don't suffer it.
I gotcha.
Does that make sense?
Wait. Mm-hmm. Okay, so, and I am there, so one. Okay, so I would suffer it now, because there's only two. Because there's this room and then there's
but this
here.
Is open. There's right. this so is that's open one. Door. So that's one, two,
and that's it.
Oh, this three. Is this hallway. This is a hallway.
But we already
yeah, but
this.
It's
this
not by it. Yeah. So yeah. Yay.
Well, this is gonna and that does that last forever?
That's gonna I believe
be,
so.
It doesn't say put it away. Yeah. That's gonna be rough. I'm going crazy first.
Oh, but what if we do
I'll shoot you with the shotgun.
So on the next turn, I need to give this back to you, so you can discard. Because it doesn't say you can't discard a face up.
Oh.
So that would be how you good, remove yes. that stuff, probably. So that we will definitely good. Do that next turn. All right. Oh, and that was it. We didn't have to do. Oh, it's because there's no monster out on the board. We didn't have to do a horror check on anything, so that was good. All right.
Now
so
here's another thing too.
Yes.
Because does that not count because we haven't opened it?
Correct. It's a locked yes, door. Yes, it's closed. So it's closed at this point. So should I come over by you and give you
we
this?
We gotta get in that corner.
Well, yeah, we gotta. Yeah. If you get that door open, that'll help me too. Because
that's
then I won't.
That's fair. All right. All right.
Now it's gonna
moving
change.
In the corner, and if something bad happens and you just sacrifice the Aggie.
It's a key.
A heavy chest sits in the corner near the bed. You notice scuff marks on the floor that indicate that it's regularly moved. Oh. Mm. You drag the chest across the wooden floor, and you hear an audible click. You look under the chest and you see a small alcove in the floor holding a jumble of electrical wiring. You seem to have triggered something, and now you can hear a steady ticking from within. You attempt to rewire the device and stop the timer. Tap to attempt a puzzle using your... That symbol is observation. I always want to call that sight.
I'm picturing my grandmother trying to set the VCR now.
I know.
That's what I'm picturing
look,
happening.
She's very smart. She's very well studied. I'm just a terrible fighter. All right, so my observation is 4. Mm. So I have 2 moves at the moment. But this is where you can actually spend clues to accomplish things. So you need to move pieces on this puzzle to be able to move this bar that looks different out into this alcove.
I can do it in 3 moves.
Okay. I have, yeah, so what, we would have to go over here? No.
That,
it's
this
4.
One?
Yeah, either
it's
up
4
or down.
Moves.
3. Put the one
the
on.
The fourth one to put it in, though, right?
Oh, does that count as a move?
I don't know.
But I've got 2, plus I've got clues here that I can spend, so okay. We'll be able to get it done. So what do we want me to do?
Far right one down.
Okay, that's 1.
And then what, that longer of the upper ones to the right?
No.
No?
No.
Because it's
one on the...
One,
oh, yeah.
Two,
three. Look at
oh
that.
Oh my gosh, yeah, that's it.
2, 3.
I forgot.
And then I will spend a clue. Look at that. We just unlocked something. Puzzle woo-hoo. Completed. You deftly cut wires and twist others together to reroute the power. And as the ticking stops, you hear a click from the other side of the wall out in the hallway. Gain 1 clue and then discard the search token. All right. So I moved and I searched. So that was all I can do. Alrighty. Who else would like to go?
I want to see if that door opens now.
Is it your turn? Go do it.
We don't have.
Do it.
I would like to. I would like to attempt to open the door.
All right. A weathered door at the end of the hall is cracked open. You hear bizarre noises from the other side. You still want to go?
Do it.
Kinda do.
All right. We're going. The smell of soil and rotting plant matter greets you as you open the door to the dimly lit conservatory. Through the windows, you can see a walled-off side yard. A massive circle of runes has been carved into the earth. Discard this explore token and place the conservatory tile as indicated. Oh, I bet we have to shift this way a little bit. All right. The cramped space is filled with yard tools and other landscaping supplies. Ooh. Among the supplies, you spot something useful. Place the axe common item as indicated. Oh, yeah. Whoops, that's a 2x4. Axe. And two robed figures stand across from each other over the ritual circle chanting. The one nearest you seems to be in some kind of trance and hardly acknowledges your approach. Spawn a cultist as indicated. So one in the corner here. The other figure lowers the hood of his robe and points at you with an ornate dagger. What are you doing on my property? You're meddling in things that you do not understand, and you'll die for it. Spawn a priest of Dagon as indicated. This is William Vanderbilt. Dun, dun, dun.
You missed it, John.
I know, right?
For that.
Focus, William, focus. One too many bumps with the trouble. William Vanderbilt begins chanting a heinous incantation and causes reality to warp and shift. A single massive creature of terrifying description slips through the fabric of reality and into our world. Spawn a star spawn as indicated.
I'm guessing it's this very ugly guy.
Is it? I think so. Yes.
Well, that seems bad.
Mm.
And that's here.
Oh,
holy moly. That takes up the whole space.
Wendy doesn't have enough shells.
Ooh.
I'm glad I'm on the other side of the building.
The ritual circle on the ground is scattered with candles, skulls, and other trinkets. If you could get these ritual components, you could stop the cult's vile magic and have enough proof to condemn the Vanderbilt family. All right, so you can move one space into the explored area, which you just did. You must interrupt the ritual taking place before it's complete. I don't know if we're in a position to do that.
No,
we haven't picked up anything. And you're all by yourself, and I'm in the far corner. All right.
All the guns are not here. I want to run away.
Yeah. Okay. Are you going to pick that up, or are you literally just running away?
Can I pick it up and move, or is
that
two moves?
No, it would be two actions.
No, I'll leave the axe and run away. I think that's the safer
bet. Are you only going one or two?
Can I go two?
You can go up to two.
Oh, well, yeah. Okay. I want to go as far. Well, although now I'm closer to that, so I don't know if that's any better.
That helps.
At least we'll all be coming out into the same
room. Go back here, and then you won't suffer a damage, though, right? Does this put you...
Oh, you're right. Well, no, because this has three.
That's
right?
Not a door here.
That's not a door. One, two, three.
Oh, good. Okay, so yeah, then good. You're fine. All right. So that
I
was your turn.
Forgot about that.
And then, one shot.
You all right, let's go.
Kill this thing.
This would not be the time to fail. I'm just saying. He's a little bigger than
us. Yeah, how many hit points does he have?
I don't know.
More than six, I'm going to guess.
He is this guy. 12.
Oh, no.
Holy,
you're going to have to shoot him
Moses.
Twice.
All right, I'm standing right there. Let's fire. Fire when ready.
Please hit him twice. The creature's erratic movements are difficult to track. Your agility. Agility 2.
That's so nice.
Oh, please hit him.
Boom. Hit him.
Score.
He gets six.
Six damage. Sweet. Oops. I'm getting a little excited. One more time?
Do it again.
You have like
if
the most
brutal gun. If you two-shot like the biggest thing
I
in
know,
the game.
Right? She's a boss. All right. As the creature's limbs writhe and flail, you wait for the moment and then fire off a single shot. Okay. Agility 2 again.
Ah!
Wendy, one shot.
What happened, Wendy?
For the miss. She technically still did have one shot, though. So you still get to keep your title.
Thank you.
Because that was
on
the
second
one.
I would hate to have missed my nickname.
Oh, brother. All right. So, whoops. Sorry about that. I am having technical difficulties. All right. Let's look here. And that, unfortunately, was our turn.
And there's so many bad guys.
Oh, this is going to go bad. And the investigator phase. I don't want to. The objects in William York has collected become crushing weights, punishing his tired limbs. William York suffers 2 damage. Your strength negates it for each damage. So, what's your strength?
My strength.
Come on, you're William York.
You'd think I'd be stronger. I'm only 4.
Ooh.
I'm not really.
What's that all about?
What do you do over there?
Nothing.
Nothing.
He's kind of mediocre. Yeah. He really is.
He digs things.
I have a shovel and this beautiful hair. Yeah.
And it is very beautiful.
I mean, don't forget I was a Shakespearean
yes,
actor.
Yes, that's true.
Don't forget
that
about that.
That's very true.
Okay, so I got to get a 1?
Whatever you roll can potentially negate 2 damage. Okay. So you would need to roll 2.
And I got nothing.
Oh, so 2 damage for you. How much total damage can you take?
7.
Oh, that's
pretty tough.
That's
You're
not so
very
bad.
Very strong.
That's not so bad.
I can get beat up a lot.
For each damage you suffer, you drop 1 random item.
Oh, okay, no. So...
Random items, so you need to shuffle those in your hand.
Is it just these 3? Those are my only items?
Or is one of those a spell?
No.
No, okay.
And how many am I losing?
2, because you suffered 2 damage.
So I'm just picking 1 here, taking that.
What'd you lose?
Good. I didn't lose the brass knuckles.
Oh, all right. Cool.
So, not that they helped me at all.
Medical textbook. All right.
I kind of wish I'd used that.
Yep.
And I cannot pick that back up.
All right. The cultist now moves 2 spaces towards the nearest investigator and attacks that investigator in its space.
Oh, good. It can't reach.
With the lowest influence.
So he gets to here, and I'm not in his space.
Yes. So 1 and 2. No. So that's good. No, none in the space. Vanderbilt moves 2 spaces.
Same thing. Oh, no. He's
2
as
same
well.
Thing.
Sweet.
Yep, because that's the only door. No investigators in that space.
Surrounded.
So then he moves 2 spaces towards the nearest investigator. What a jerk. You can't move twice.
He's
Not
cheating.
Cool. All right. So... Oh, but it didn't attack. He moved again. Okay, that's not terrible. Starspawn moves 1 space towards the nearest investigator, and then it attacks the investigator in that space or adjacent space who has suffered the least damage.
I got 2.
I've got 2.
Rock, paper, scissors.
I'll take the fight.
Well, here, how many? You got 6. I got 7.
All right, you
I can take
the fight.
More.
All right.
I can take
Hit him with your brass knuckles.
The creature's
Working
powerful,
so well.
Rubbery hand closes around you and lifts you effortlessly into the air and then hurls you back to the ground. Suffer 2 damage and become dazed. Oh, you don't even get to roll against that.
Thanks for making him angry.
Because he's bad and you're dazed. Would you find
Where's
him
the...
a dazed condition?
Oh, absolutely.
Are you dazed and confused? Probably. That's what I want to know.
Most likely.
Each investigator must resolve a horror check against the monster within range of the highest horror rating. Gee, I wonder who that would be.
It's going to be tough to figure that one out.
Yeah, and I'm pretty sure, what is his awareness? Can we see?
5.
Okay, yeah, so it affects me too, so we each have to do it. So, yes, we're resolving a horror check. The air seems to thin near the creature, and you find yourself struggling to breathe. Your skin burns, and your stomach fills with icy cold. So we're rolling our strength. Oh, good, because I'm really strong.
Me too.
I get to roll 2. Seriously?
There you go. Go ahead, start the party.
If you pass, and I have to roll both successes. Oh, my goodness.
Ooh.
But I rolled 2 failures. Does that count for anything?
It wasn't even close.
So
feel
I
bad.
Get...
The monster feels sorry for you.
If you fail, you try to scream, but chill racks your body in as you empty your stomach upon the ground. Sorry, I just threw up all over the floor.
Thank goodness. In the bedroom.
Suffer 2 horror and become dazed. Am I insane? 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. All right.
Oh, you're cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs
Cuckoo
now.
For Cocoa Puffs. So when you go insane, I cash in these insanity markers here, and I take an insane condition. Is that this pile? Yes.
Top one.
So the first, that is the top one. All right. So what happens with this is I look at the top of this, and it says, look at the back of this card. Do not reveal it to the other players. And now if I suffer additional horror up to the nine that I can, then I'm officially out of the game. But now I have a secret agenda. Okay. And so it might send you on a crazy secondary objective. Nothing may happen. You may start behaving just completely erratically. And I can't tell you guys what's going on. So you'll just have to figure it out. Is she cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs or is she just crazy Agatha? It's really hard to tell.
Now she's a weak, crazy old lady.
Maybe I will be super effective now. Don't know.
That could be. I got one.
One. That's not going to do it. So if you fail, you try to scream, chill wrecks your body. You also vomit, probably because you saw me vomit. And then you suffer two horror and you're dazed.
Oh, my goodness.
So how much?
Thank you.
What are you
at? Oh, we're getting close here. I got six.
All gonna go crazy.
Oh, seven. One more and I go crazy.
So give yourself a dazed.
Oh, brother.
All right, William. Can you do it? How strong are you?
I'm 4 strength.
All right, come on. You need 2.
Come on, 2. I got it.
Woo! Show off. If you pass, you manage to wrest control of your faculties enough to stand. Flip one horror face up, so one that you already have. And then suffer one face down horror. Oh, you still suffer something no matter what. That's pretty rotten. But
So I flip another one face up?
No, that's you got to just change one that you already had and you still just take one. So and what is it now?
I didn't do anything with it. So flip.
No, read it. No, you read. What did you just flip up?
I didn't flip it up.
This has been flipped up. Oh, that's the
whole
other
time.
One.
That's
well, you
what
need
I'm
to
saying.
Flip another one.
That's what I was saying. I need to flip another.
Yes.
Minor shock. Your heart races. Oh, here. Let's see. I can do that. Your heart races and your breath catches in your throat. Resolve immediately. No additional effect. Flip this card face down.
Oh, there you go.
Okay. So
nice.
It was just something for. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm.
Are you insane too?
Oh man, now you're nuts too.
Now things are really gonna get interesting.
I know, it's getting ugly around here.
Wait. No, I'm not. This is a dazed. I'm sorry. One, two, three, four, five. I've got one more. I thought this was a.
Gotcha.
I'll keep your crazy ready for you.
Yeah, you keep it handy because I'm gonna need it.
Keep it close. It's coming. All right. Yes, end the mythos phase for the love of goodness. Let's kill this guy, shall we?
All right. I am dazed, so I only get to do one thing during
my
turn.
So you're gonna shoot at the bad thing.
I'm gonna shoot at it.
All right,
just do it.
Do it to it. So please, hopefully it's your agility. Yes, you're gonna use firearm. You're going to loathe to trust your aim at range. You resolve to stand your ground until the monster moves closer. And as it does, your hands begin to tremble. So now you're going to use your willpower. You need to roll willpower of 2.
Oh no, gosh.
And you've got 3. Come on, you can do it.
Come on, Wendy. You got a big gun. Oh, I did not get one.
So if you fail, the trembling intensifies, and it's all you can do to keep from dropping your weapon. Oh, that's kind of terrible. Well, that was disappointing.
It was.
All right.
My turn is done.
I can go and punch him.
I have a gun. Would you like me to move up and take a shot? Or do you want to see how you do with it
Why don't
first?
We see how I do? Because there's plenty of bad guys.
All right.
You can shoot anyone else, too. That would be. All right. So.
All right. Are you going after him or are you going after...
I want to get rid of this big thing because he's kind of scary.
If you could take him out with brass knuckles, I would be the biggest fan ever.
Mm-hmm. I really don't think I can, but
attack.
That would be awesome.
Unarmed. And it's going to say, are you crazy? No. It says, as the creature lunges, snarling and snapping towards you, you nimbly dance out of its way with your fierce dance moves, luring it closer to some misadventure. Your agility, +1. What is your agility?
Good. Not great. 3, so I get 4.
4. Well, that's not terrible.
It's not horrible. So.
And he suffers
equal
damage
to equal to your results. Test so results. I can't kill him. The most I could do would be 4.
Yeah.
Come on. Punch him. 2.
All right. continue. Would you like to try that again? What would you like to do?
Yes, I would.
Okay.
I would.
Are you dazed?
But it's a different dazed. I am dazed, but it's not.
What is your condition?
I can't spend clues to convert my dice.
Oh, all right.
So I will allow.
All right.
Is it going to be? Oh, good. Strength this time.
Yep,
that's
you
much
leap
better.
At the creature and hammer it with your fists. So use your strength of 2. All right.
So my strength, and I actually get, I'm going to roll 3 twice because I actually get 6
dice.
Oh,
nice. Yeah, we really could use a couple more dice.
Strength is good. Okay, there's 1.
Come on.
I need 1 more. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
2. Oh, wait, but he's 12. So he's still alive and kicking, unfortunately. All right.
Here's where Agatha runs in.
Auntie Aggie's
kind of
trying to run to the rescue here. Should I just move up 1 and shoot at it?
Yes.
That's what I'm thinking, rather than in the same space.
You mean you don't want to be between all the bad guys?
It's probably not going to matter. I'm going to get affected by him no matter what. But all right, so.
And then that gets discarded.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there you go.
Thank you.
All right, so I'm going to attack with a firearm. As the creature's limbs writhe and flail, you wait for your moment and you fire off a single shot. My agility. Oh, okay. 3. My stats are terrible. God, I have a gun. Not that it's done me a bit of good. 1. Nope. If you fail, you're certain that you hit, but the monster seems unconcerned. Okay. 1 more time.
Do you get to attack again? Because you moved 1.
Oh, I did. Son of a gun. Nope, you are right.
Party's over.
You think I'm the crazy one. I'm helping the monster.
I know, right? Whose side are you on, William? Seriously. All right.
Well, I'm not sure.
This may be the end. All right. A few lights around Wendy Adams flash sporadically and somehow bring back memories of guilt and terror. Wendy Adams suffers 2 horror. Your willpower negates it. So roll your willpower.
Oh.
Come on.
Come on, we can do it. We can do it. Ooh, 1.
You negate 1. And are you crazy now?
I think I just did go crazy. I did. And so I got to get an insane card. Oh, man. Bye-bye.
I will laugh if you become a pyromaniac again. The last time we played this game, Wendy was a pyromaniac and all she wanted to do was set fires. So. Oh. All right. The cultist now moves 2 spaces towards the nearest investigator, and it attacks that investigator. So he moves up here with William Vanderbilt and attacks. All right, which one of you is it attacking?
Who is it? The lowest agility?
Yeah.
I have 5.
I'm the lowest agility, yeah.
So it's coming after you?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, okay.
He's pretty excited. Yes.
All right, so he attacks. He wraps grimy hands around your neck, squeezing tight. You suffer 3 face-down damage. Ooh, why is he so strong?
Right? All right,
strength. Strength minus 1 negates.
So I get 3. And I got to get... Oh, and it's...
Yeah.
3 damage, so I gotta really get 3.
It'll negate 1 apiece. Oh, 1. So you get 2?
Yeah.
All right. What happens there?
I need a Band-Aid.
Are you dead? No.
Not yet.
No, I'm not dead.
He's working on it, though.
I'm real close.
All right. Starspawn moves 1 space towards the nearest investigator.
No need.
He attacks with the highest
observation. Which one of you has the highest observation?
4. What about you? Why are you not involved?
Because I'm an extra space over.
I'm crazy, but I only got 2 hits. I'll go for it.
All right. Monster attacks. The massive creatures every moment causes an explosion of debris in the landscape, gives way before it. Your strength 2 you need to roll. Strength of 2, so.
All right.
What is your strength?
3.
3? Come on, Wendy.
Ooh, Wendy is a weak kid.
An epic fail.
These are the worst dice rolls ever.
Oh, my goodness. If you fail, several pieces strike your head, suffer 2 damage, and become dazed.
Oh, man. How come I'm always getting dazed? I can't
know.
Become stunned or restrained.
You're dazed and crazy.
No, right? Yeah.
Let me see what my days did.
Each investigator must resolve a horror check against a monster within range of the highest horror rating. After all horror checks have been resolved, tap the end phase. All right, so we're taking the horror check against the big guy here again.
Oh,
so
no.
I'm assuming it's our lore. Yeah. Creature looks at you with immense disdain. All right, so I have a lore of 4.
Hey, I rhymed.
It's willpower.
Oh, it's willpower? Wait, yeah, that's what I meant.
The pictures
read
are
my
weird.
Mind. Yeah. Oh, terrible. If you fail, you fall to your knees, babbling in hopeless tongues, you suffer 2 horror and become stunned. Fabulous. Mm. Let's be more crazy than I am already.
Get you stunned while we're over here. Here you go.
Thanks. Cannot perform more than a single action. Awesome. All right. Which one of you would like to go?
Oh.
Come on, crazy.
All right. I am going to attack the monster.
You can't.
We're rolling against the defense thing now. She is
crazy.
She is crazy.
Let allow us to reorient.
Her card says, pretend to not understand how to play anymore.
Maybe your card says you can attack in the mythos phase, and we just don't know it.
Randomly attack everything around
you. That's what I want to do. All right, what am I rolling? I'm rolling my observation.
Your willpower.
Oh, I hate that.
You've gotten out and you ate the whole chocolate cake.
Thank you. Here's some more crazy.
That's a stinger. I needed more crazy to add to my
you
already
should have
insane.
Attacked him. Right. You're sure, William.
This is for crazy.
Yes, you can do it.
I'm crazy.
You are super crazy. Oh, you're officially crazy
well.
Too. This is going to become like the most non-productive.
Do I need these?
No, you just give them back. And give them a crazy.
Let me get you crazy here. Join the club. You'll just start attacking things.
Oh, does that go too then?
What is it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Good. Get rid of that.
Yes.
My claustrophobia. What are you doing?
Give me your
crazy. I'm crazy.
Yeah,
that's
read it and
I
then
forgot.
Read the back and keep the back a secret.
Yeah, don't tell us. All right, yes, end the mythos phase for love of all things holy. All right. So, meanwhile, in the ranch, we still need to take care of these monsters. I can shoot at it. Mm-hmm. I can only do 1 action, but I'll try.
Do it. Do your
all
action.
All right, I will try. So... I'm going to attack with a firearm. Loath to trust your aim at close range, resolve to stand your ground. As you close your hands, you begin to tremble. Willpower. Hey.
Stand
all right,
your
that's
ground.
4. Can I have... I may
he was
use...
coming right for me.
I may use... Yes, I'm going to look at him sternly. The glasses with my librarian glare.
Pull them down just a little.
And I failed yet again. Have I succeeded in a single roll in this whole game?
Not at shooting anything.
Oh, wait.
It's crazy
better.
Already runs
it
around with a gun.
It gets better. If you fail, trembling intensifies, and it's like, can keep dropping your weapon. I thought I actually dropped my weapon or perhaps hurt myself. So shall I try it again? Oh, I can't. I'm
yeah,
stunned.
Let me get in the other room first. Go
done.
Ahead.
Look, you guys. All right.
Do it again.
No, I can't do it again. I'm stunned. Aww. So which one of you?
I'm going to shoot at it.
Which one of you crazy geniuses would like to shoot at
it?
Oh, wait. Here, you know what? Let me punch it because it's got very little hit points. No, because I can barely do any damage.
That may be the craziest thing I've ever heard.
You might be able to kill the other guys with your shotgun blast, whereas I just need to get a glancing blow on this thing to kill it, right?
Yeah. Okay.
Stop making so much sense. Mm-hmm.
It's never going to work.
Attack unarmed.
It's never going to work.
You dodge behind the creature, hoping to strike it from behind will prove more effective than a frontal attack. Your
totally doing
agility.
This.
Flying crane for the win.
Oh, it's my agility?
Your
That's
agility.
Not what I wanted to hear.
Mm. That's you gave not it to good. The girl with the 5 agility. I'm just saying.
I get 2 extra anyway, though. So I still get 5. Or not 6, but 5. I like that. Okay, never mind. Agility's fine then.
No, his card
not.
Says
oh,
he should
it.
Ramble incessantly to himself. What you get?
I got it.
All right. Whew. If you pass, your theory proves inaccurate. Your strikes cause the creature to lurch and wheel around. The monster
yes,
suffers damage
us.
Equal to your test result plus 1. So what did you roll?
So two. And that killed it. Thank goodness. So you get a clue. Get a clue.
You love saying
it's,
that.
I do. It never gets
I'll
old.
Take the monster.
Take the monster. Oh, okay.
No one saw that.
All right. So that was one action. Is that the only thing you can do, or can you do a second action?
No, I can do.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not dazed or anything.
Have a crack at one of these.
Oh boy.
Go after a tough guy here.
Okay.
He's stronger. He was doing 3 damage at a time.
Although I see, I might have a chance of killing him, and she can still shotgun blast either of them.
Is that what you want to do?
I'm going to punch the weaker guy.
All right. Punch a cultist.
I just beat the big thing. Come on.
Sounds like a great punch game. Punch a cultist.
It's a carnival.
Yeah. You throw a low punch at your foe's gut, and the figure curls over to avoid the first hit. You swing your other fist towards his exposed head. Your strength. You need strength of 2.
Okay.
To get him.
So I get 6. So I'm going to roll 3 twice.
Surely
again.
You can get 2.
Hey, I got on the first one. I didn't need to roll the rest.
Show off. All right. If you pass, your fist impacts your foe's temple, knocking it for a loop, and the monster suffers 3 damage. All right. So that's all you can do. So he's still with us, but that was good.
Should have been for more.
That was good. All right, one shot.
I'm going to shoot the big bad guy.
All right.
I'm going to go for
this guy?
Yeah.
Do with the hat. He's got a fancy hat. Yeah. A Pope hat, if you will.
So attack with a firearm. Your hands shake as adrenaline pumps through your veins. You open fire despite the difficulty. So your agility of 2.
Yes.
Come on.
That's my strong suit.
Yes, and it still is. If you pass, your marksmanship overcomes your uncooperative limbs. The monster suffers damage equal to the weapon's damage. Oh, 6. That's a
good thing it's a shotgun.
Thing. Can you only do 1 thing still?
No. My dazed was that I couldn't use.
Oh, good.
My tokens.
Good, good, good. All right. Would you like to try that again?
I will. I will shoot him.
We would love that. You empty your weapon at the figure's center mass. Agility again. Mm. Do it.
Come on.
Yes. Yeah, with conviction. All right. It staggers backward. The monster takes damage equal to,
That would have been cool, though, if you'd pushed him back, because then it would have been like a shotgun.
Right? Yeah, that one was kind of real, so that's cool. Nice. Hey, get a clue.
Oh, yeah.
And I think that was everybody, right?
Did you go?
I start wildly
at the ceiling.
Remember?
Oh, that's right. That's right. Absolutely nothing happened.
It
whizzed
past your head.
I totally forgot.
You're like, not at me. Not at me.
Now it's coming back.
Oh, gosh. I don't want to.
Add 17 creatures.
William York's limbs are wrenched into impossible angles by invisible forces. William York suffers
4 damage.
Damage.
I can't possibly take that much.
Your strength negates it. Strength
okay,
plus
so
1.
Okay, so 5.
Strength, yeah, come on.
I need 1 more. Okay, 5.
I'll get your wounded card ready.
Thank you. 2? Does that...
So you negate 2. So you
That's
suffer 2.
That's still too much.
2.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, I'm still...
All right, so you're wounded. All right, so William's character has now become wounded.
I'm crazy wounded.
What does your status say for wounded? That one you can read out loud.
I cannot perform the move action more than once each round. Okay. When you have suffered damage equal to your health, I'm eliminated. Okay.
That's not terrible. All right. Cultist moves 2 spaces towards the nearest investigator and attacks the investigator in its space with the lowest agility.
That's me again.
That's you again. All right, the monster attacks. The cultist hooks 1 arm around you and then pounds you with a fist and knee over and over. Suffer 2 face-down damage. Your strength negates. So roll
and
your
strength.
And
I might become dazed as well. Isn't that lovely?
Come on, you can block 2. Or not. You blocked 1?
Wow.
Okay, so you take 1. If you suffer 1 or more damage, you get dazed. All right, did you give him a dazed token?
Boy, I am not doing good at all.
No. Each investigator must now resolve a horror check against a monster within range of the highest horror rating. Okay, so he's the only one. Great. So yes, we're going to resolve a horror check. The cultist pulls an urn from a bench, a voluminous cloak, and uncovers its mouth.
A dozen foot-long centipedes burst from the jar in your direction, tumbling through the air. We need to roll our agility of one. If you pass, you can evade the horde swarm. So everybody roll their agility. You just need one to succeed. No, not one die. Is your what your agility is. You just need to roll one success with your agility.
I was feeling confident.
Yeah. I got this.
I shouldn't have been feeling confident.
If you fail.
I'm covered in centipedes.
The majority of centipedes land on your chest and crawl over your face, suffer two face down horror. Ew. Alright, Wendy. You roll your agility.
Rolling my agility.
Wow, you are like five. Super agile.
Ooh, I should be able to ninja swipe these away, no problem.
You got this.
Bum.
Got this. Alright, and I am agility.
You couldn't have swatted a few away from
of
me.
Three. No, we were too busy laughing. We're crazy. We find that funny. And exactly. Don't worry, I'm gonna join you. Blah. Crawling all over me. Great. Great. Crazy it is. So that is the end of that painful, painful mythos phase.
I'm all right. Mostly dead.
Let's let Agatha attack him again. Just all right, for the
yes. Humor. You just want to watch me do something horrible with this gun again. All right, I'll play. It's fine. One of these days, I'm going to hit something, and you are going to be so impressed.
It's going to be you.
I'm going to shoot
you. You aim for your foe's center mass. Agility plus one. All right, my agility is three, so I get to roll four dice this time.
You got this, Agatha.
Come on.
I totally
right.
Headshot.
With conviction. So she put it her suffers damage nice. Equal to my test result. So.
Oh, open my eyes.
I didn't. I just killed the cultist. It's the only thing Agatha has accomplished this game. I would just
good
like
job.
To go on the record. My work here is done. Yeah. So that was one move.
All right.
I'm kind of scared to go do anything else. All right. We still have two rooms to go into.
Wait, did I go yet?
Yeah, that was from.
Do I go here, or should I come this way?
You might as well go here. It's close.
Oh, I'm not gonna be able to. I'm only gonna be able to move anyway.
Okay.
So 1, 2, there I am. All right, peoples, what would you like to do?
Well, I can go check it.
Check it. Can you do two?
No, you can only do one thing.
I can move one.
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah, he just can't double
move once.
All right. Yeah. Are you sure you can with that wound? You're all right.
Hey, I'm crazy, not crazy. Wait.
All right.
You're both.
A wood plaque marked library is fastened to the center of this door.
Now I can understand if I deduce there might be a library behind this door.
The door creaks on its hinges as you push it open to reveal a library. Bookshelves line the walls. Discard this explore token. Place a library tile and a wall. As indicated. I'll give you the wall. You put the library token there. So that's not actually a door. All right. And is there anything in there? There is something in there. In the corner. A pile of research materials that have been recently used sits a small wooden desk. Place a search token as indicated. Okay. Oh, and one more. A robed figure is pushing a bookshelf back into place. Place a search token as indicated. Ah, well, hopefully that means he's not there. Is he on the other side of it? No, he's in there. A robed figure draws out a strange idol and begins chanting. Before your very eyes, a terrifying creature appears out of thin air. A cult member speaks some words in a strange language, and then the creature turns to him, tearing him to pieces before your eyes. Spawn a deep one in the library, as indicated, and then suffer two horror. Your willpower negates it.
Okay.
So roll your willpower. And I'm assuming that means you're in there. They didn't say that, but...
I get one horror, then?
Yep. All right. I move one space into the explored area, okay, which we had. All right. And Wendy?
Oh my, the options. I'm going to move into this room. And then I suppose I should shotgun blast our friend for us all.
That would be awesome if you could.
Meaning the monster, not me, right?
Yeah.
Well, you're insane and wounded. I might want to put you out of your misery.
You brace yourself in a proper shooter stance. Aim and fire. Your agility. You need agility of two.
There we go.
Come on, kill it with your agility.
Oh, look at that. Yes. This monster suffers damage equal to the weapon's damage. Nice. Oh, six. Yes. That was amazing.
Shotgun is the one to have.
Wendy.
Yeah.
For the win.
Seeing as how everything has, well, not everything, but a lot of them have 6 hit points. Yes.
What you need is a ninja urchin with a shotgun.
All right, so you moved and shot, and that was all of us.
That's all I could
do. Oh, I don't want to. We just cleared everything. the cheap item snaps as Agatha Crane tries to lift it. Unfortunately, it's now completely useless. Agatha Crane discards one random common item.
Oh. Well, I'm going to discard my King James. Oh, one random. Oh, John.
I'm just saying, you made me do it. I'm just going
to. I know. All right, common items. These are common items. So I have four of them. Oh, if I drop my gun, because it's been very useless. I hit something one time in this game with my gun. I'm just saying. It's my gun. Terrible.
She's the most wonderful old lady ever.
Someday when I'm dead, you're going to regret saying that.
I've still got my Burt's beeswax.
A deafening roar overtakes the yard as the ritual completes and a portal to another world opens.
Flower bushes
are uprooted in the air in the yard and is sucked from a portal to some unknown abyss. The conservatory windows shatter and various tools and yard equipment fly through the open gate. Discard the interact token and any items in the conservatory and garden path.
The axe.
Did we fail? Or was...
Not yet, but you're about to.
Thinking we're...
The air is electric and an unearthly energy, and the entire scene is bathed in a sickly green glow. On the other side of a massive rift, bizarre cyclopean architecture of Craven Rock is built at angles that defy understanding. An inhuman script adorns the structures, winding over their surfaces. Place an interact token as indicated. Okay. A different interact token.
Well, we're not dead yet then.
We guess we have to go right back over there though. The investigation is complete if the portal has been closed before it tears the mansion to pieces. Investigators win the game when the investigation is complete. So we need to try to go close that portal. Did it say if we need anything to close that portal?
I mean, yeah, I'm like, what? I didn't bring my portal closer.
I know. Left that in your other pants, did you?
Should have reminded me to bring it.
All right. And that's, are we in the investigator's turn? No, we're in the investigator's phase. All right, so what do we want to do?
I don't know whether we need stuff or we need to just run
over
there. I'm going to
move one and
I'm
look
hoping
at this.
That's a secret passage. Wouldn't that be handy?
Well, it should because the guy was just closing it.
That's what I was thinking. Peering behind the bookshelf, the robed figure was moving. You see runic circles described on the wall. You push aside the shelf and attempt to decipher the strange ritual markings on the wall. Tap to attempt a puzzle. Oh, it's a puzzle. Using your lore.
Oh, it's an actual puzzle.
I'm using my
puzzle,
lore.
Puzzle, puzzle, puzzle.
I got three of these. I wish John was going, because he's got like 80.
So three?
Oh, my God. I was trying to cheat.
Cheater. She is crazy. The counting was the first thing to go. Oh, one.
I got four moves.
All right. What do we want to do? Then. So this is a slide puzzle. This looks like the middle. No? Wait.
I know the...
Oh.
That's the one over on this side in the middle. That goes at the top. Nope. That wasn't one I was talking about. The one next to it.
This one.
Yeah. That goes up in the corner.
There's a hole. All right.
Look at that. One. That looks right, too.
Yeah, that one's correct.
That we accidentally...
And then this one goes over there.
This one does?
Yeah.
Cheater doing the corners first.
Yep.
That's how you do a puzzle.
Yeah, just kidding.
Oh, that's a palm. So that goes in the middle, but you can't move that way, I bet. But
It would take two moves.
How many we got left? We got two left. You might as well do it and put it there.
Is that what we want this one then? Mm-hmm. So go
one. And then up. And that one's in the right place.
Two. All right, so that's four moves. Is that all you had?
That's all I had.
Bummer. All right, so that's all we can do this turn. But now one of us can go and interact with it on another turn. All right, so
What did you use for that, lore?
Yeah.
That and then probably these. Ought to be you then.
You moved, you moved and did that, right? So that was your two actions.
So you have all these. Yeah. Those are all turns.
True. I was just saying, but she has better lore than I do to begin with.
So all you can move one and then finish the puzzle.
Is that what you'd like to do?
Apparently that's what she wants me to do. Even though I'm not the lore
guy. She has been the most successful in the game so far. So I'm just thinking we probably should listen to her. All right.
All right.
So yes, we're going to attempt the puzzle. It didn't save. Wait, yes, it did. It saved where we were at. Okay, so you need to roll your lore.
And that's three. And then can I use two of these to make those wins?
Yes.
Not that nice. We need all those, but yep. Let's.
All right, so three. And how would we like to?
Well, those are the fingers.
So that would be one, two. Okay. This does not belong here. Does this go all the way up here?
I'm going to say the middle left one looks like the bottom middle one.
Mm-hmm.
This one?
I agree with Dan.
Or this the middle left. Middle left, yeah. That one should be the bottom middle.
Mm-hmm. Here.
Yeah.
All right.
Do you have to stop, or can you take it from there?
You can only move one.
Oh, gotcha.
Yep, only adjacent. So you could move this up. And then move it like this, which would bring this here to bring it. It's going to require a bunch of moves, unfortunately.
Okay. He's got a bunch of tokens.
But don't they only get three?
No, he gets to use these.
But I thought that was just to change your dice. Is that not just to change your dice?
No, I thought you could turn those in for puzzle moves.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, is it?
For extra moves, yeah. This is the only instance that you can do that. So, but.
Well, then however moves it takes.
So there's one and two.
Mm-hmm.
Three. All right, that worked.
Mm-hmm.
And then is it just these two?
I think so.
Ha! Oh, score! Please go out there. Puzzle completed. Seeing a pattern overlapping circles, you trace a continuous line through the winding markings. The runes illuminate with a strange green light, and a wall panel pops open, revealing a secret door to a hidden study behind the wall. Gain one clue, and then discard this. Search.
Let me move my friend.
The screen panel on the wall slides open noiselessly and you peer into a hidden office. Place the office tile with the wall indicated. That's not out to the yard like I was hoping. There's a search token. Oh, we gotta wait until William gets the tile there.
It would help if they had a picture signed to which one the office was.
That's office.
I know, but it's very small writing.
Just saying.
Well, if you see that, it might be one of these.
Oh.
See, an actual picture would be nice because I'd have an idea of what I'm looking
like
for.
It looks like a long.
Is it? I didn't see it. Maybe I just missed it.
Are they double-sided? Yes.
Oh, they totally are double-sided. Okay. That's exactly what it is.
It's a little cray-cray. Yeah. Just saying.
Crazy and blonde is no way to go through life, William.
There's the option. I didn't realize they were double-sided. Where does it go?
Right here.
Needs help with all of it.
No, turn it.
Oh. Okay. I couldn't see the picture. That was the problem. I literally could not see the picture and I didn't know where it was.
Token. All right. Oh, one more search token. And you can move into that room. And then is it my turn?
Mm-hmm.
I can't even get over there, I don't think.
That's okay.
Do I move up and search that thing?
I will. All right.
A little scared. Large scroll showing the solar systems. Okay. Scroll is marked by the orbits of eight planets. A straight line is drawn out across them, marked with today's date and the words planetary alignment. Gain one clue and then discard. That's kind of boring. On the upside, nothing died.
True.
That seriously was it. And now it's the mythos phase. And the investigator phase. And now we're at the mythos phase. Wendy Adams' bones creak and become brittle and as stale bread. Wendy Adams suffers 2 face-down damage and 2 horror. All right, so Wendy, it just took like a ridiculous amount of stuff. That was not cool. But that was the only thing in the mythos phase. So that wasn't...
Well, I have to get my cards because I didn't get... I was supposed to take 2 damage and then flip three of them.
Oh, flip them up. Okay.
2 damage, yeah, because 2 horror.
Well, we gave you the damage, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, we gave you the damage. It was the horror cards that we didn't flip.
Three of these up. Yeah. I'm disoriented. You
barely noticeable.
Your wits desert you.
Just say it.
Leaving you mumbling and uncertain. How could what you have seen be real? Resolve immediately. Become dazed and then flip this card face down.
I think you're already dazed, right?
No, I wasn't, but now I am. I'm insane.
Okay.
And then this one says, I stagger backwards in alarm. Resolve immediately, no effect, discard.
Okay. Oh, that's good.
Get rid of that one. And my third one, you whimper as your mind rejects the impossible. Resolve immediately and suffer 1 additional face down horror for each spell you have, which I have none.
All right. Woo. Oh, that's good. So nice.
Then flip this card face down.
Sweet.
All right.
All right. And the that was in the investigator phase. Oh no, we're in the investigator phase because I clicked off of that. All right, so what would we like to do? Look at the stuff in here.
Mm-hmm.
All right, you're already there. Do you want to look at whatever that is in the corner?
We started over this turn.
Yes.
Okay. Oh yeah, it was just all the bad stuff was for you. Yeah, I'll go ahead and check out this.
The shelf is lined with curiosities from the mundane to the horrifying. As you scan over the various items, your eyes fall on an urn marked Lilith Vanderbilt, 1856 to 1925. You pick up the urn and find it's filled with ashes. Do you smash the urn?
I love that option. I would totally have left it, but the option is there, so I'm going to smash the urn.
Smash it. All right. You smash the urn in a cloud of ash and broken porcelain. I mean, really, it can't be any worse than the centipedes crawling all over.
That's true.
I'm just saying. Maybe it kills the centipedes. The room seems to chill as you find an object amidst the ashes. You pick it up, and you hear the sound of a woman weeping. Gain the Elder Sign Pendant Common item, and then discard the search token. Would you find the Elder Sign Common item, which will be in...
Ritual Common?
Are those common?
Yes.
All right, and discard the search token, which we did. Can you only do 1 action, or can you do 2?
I can do 2.
Okay, what else would you like to do?
I guess I could just move to the other side of the room. Okay. That's really the only thing left.
Yeah. All right. And I can only move once in my turn, so I can move into that room, and then that's all I can do, sadly.
Wait.
Can I... Arcane Manuscript. Okay, discard. Discard 1. Okay. You or another investigator within range can discard 1 horror card and then flip this card. I will move 2 spaces into this room and then...
What was I looking for?
I will do
for you?
That. The Arcane Manuscript, I think. Hold on.
No, it was an amulet, wasn't it? None of us know. That's even better. I thought it was the pennant.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
What game are we playing?
I love that it was 100 cards in.
This game genuinely drives you insane.
I would like to say I am insane and dazed. Yeah. So I was proud of
in her defense.
Yes. That looks like an
the
amulet.
The cult sigil?
No, I don't think that's it.
I like how you drop it like it's hot there, John.
I didn't drop it if it never made it into my hand. That was you dropped it.
I'm going to use Instill Bravery on you to remove one of these horror cards.
Thank you.
Here, I'll look for
it. All right,
you
try those.
Play, because I
and then flip this card. You feel if your mind is twisting and stretching, I have to roll my lore. Oh, it costs me something to do this. Oh. See if I'm nice to you anymore. My lore, or my will. No, it's lore, is 5. Can I have those other 3 dice?
Oh, sorry. Yes.
And I have to roll 2. Which I do for a change. Oh my gosh. If you pass, you gain perspective and flip one horror face down. Well, big deal. I don't have one face up.
Is there another pile of these?
And then discard this card and gain another Instill Bravery card. I think it's in this one. It is. Lucky, what are we looking for? A pendant.
Yeah.
Who's on first?
I don't know.
Big My pendant. Turn's done. Somebody else go. All Who right. hasn't gone yet? Wendy?
Wendy. Wendy's going to come running in here. And she's going to check that out.
Check it out. The oak desk has been kept in good condition. A number of papers and books are neatly stored on the desk surface. On the desk, you find what looks like a personal planner. As you pick up the book, a brass key clatters from between the pages. You turn the page it's been holding and you find a note scrawled here. If the alignment truly weakens the veil, I believe it's the only moment we have to break through. I will make the necessary preparations in the yard. Gain the brass key and incriminating evidence unique items. Okay, those are 2 unique items. That's not in this pile.
I just saw those, so I will
And
grab
here is
those.
The elder pendant.
Yay, okay. What am I looking for? I'm looking for the key and the... was key. It circumstantial evidence in a key?
Incriminating evidence. Brass key Some and incriminating evidence. Evidence. Would you like me to look through part? Brass key and incriminating evidence. You place the planner back onto the desk and search through the drawers. You find some things of use, but no additional evidence. Gain the lucky cigarette case common item, and then discard this token.
There's those 2.
For you. Lucky cigarette case. That's because that's in here. Here you go.
Thank you.
That one was right on top. Yay! All right. And discard the search token. And that was all 3 of us again, right? Unfortunately.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So, in the investigator phase, I don't want to. The lights flicker and then go out. Place darkness in each space in the office and office.
Do we have 2 labeled office?
Apparently. Alright. So, that's the office, and then I don't know, one of these islands? Is this an office? No.
This is study.
Study.
Or is it supposed to be both
oh,
sides?
Oh, maybe it's,
office?
Yes, that's what it is. Good call. All right. And then the Smithos event affects investigators in that space containing darkness.
Every single one
All
of us.
All of us. Great to resolve awesome. The events. A low groan from beneath your feet. So use your willpower of 2 you need to roll to pass. My willpower is 4. And I failed, of course. I suffer 1 horror and move 1 space away from the office. All right. There. And you guys?
I also have a card that says that once per round, I can convert a magnifying glass to a star.
Nice.
And I need it.
And you needed that. Excellent. All right. So if you pass, you convince yourself it's just the house. You suffer 1 face down whore. Really, you suffer anyway. If you fail, you become convinced. Okay.
This house is settling.
Yeah.
All right. And I'm going to get kicked out too.
So you get 1 whore and you move 1 space away. Okay.
I move 2, right. But that is the only way to move away.
Yes.
Is that right? Okay.
All right, back to our phase. Ooh, no new monsters, though. All right. I'm assuming we literally need to hightail it back over to here, right?
That would be my guess.
And I sadly, can I... Oh, I got rid of that condition, so I can move twice again, which is nice. So I will run this way. I'll go 1,
2, and 1 and 2. Which one of you guys would like to go?
I can go because I only get to move once. So.
Oh, yep.
And I also only get to move once.
Bummer.
We're very slowly following the old lady. We can't keep up.
I know, right? Yeah. You whippersnappers just don't understand. Something moves in the darkness. This mythical event affects each investigator in something containing darkness, which is me.
Oh.
There's darkness in my room. Why is this mouse behaving badly? Try that again. There we go. Scurrying sound intensifies, scratching and muttering close enough to touch. You feel something moving just beyond reach of your fingers. Suffer 2 face down horror. Oh, I don't even get to. Oh, boy.
Are you 2, crazy again?
4, 6, 7. I get 2 more. 2 more.
Don't forget your flask. You can do the flask and get rid of a thing.
Yes, as an action. I can do that. I was just trying to get over here.
Dude, the only one's going to make it.
Guess what? And that's slow. Yeah, and that was our turn. We're back to our phase now. So, shall I?
Do it.
All right. 2 spaces, and I'm going to interact. And it so help me if it tells me we don't have what we need. A rift in the very fabric of reality. Peer into an alien landscape. Cyclopean architecture marked with an eldritch script looms on the other side. Go into the portal. You step through. I don't have the key. I hope I don't have to have that key.
You mean the brass key that's
yes.
way in line
you
back here?
You step through the rift to the other side of reality and attempt to decipher the script on the buildings. Tap to attempt the puzzle using your lore.
Well, at least your lore.
Oh boy. All right. My lore is 5, which is awesome. Can I have the dice? All right. 1. And there is 2 clue tokens here. I think you can spend the clues no matter what, though. Mm-hmm. So, all right. So, we have to decipher a code. And so we pick however many we want. You make a guess. And then it'll tell us kind of how many are right or how many are right, but not in the correct place. Or nothing at all.
Okay.
So we're just gonna wing it. And take a guess.
So the first one's
blue is right. Oh, it's only 4. Oh, wait. Oh. So 3 of the rest of these are right. How can that be if one's not? Oh, it's a repeater. So there's a second blue. Because if there's only these magnifying glasses mean you have 3 others of the right symbols, but they're not in the right. That was all I could do.
I don't understand. What
that I don't either. That is so hard. I need a hint. We don't have any hints.
I just don't understand what it's trying to tell us.
All right, what can you guys do? Move 1, move 2 spaces apiece.
Move 2 spaces each, and we'll meet him.
And what happens to us?
We're all gonna
die. I have a bad feeling somebody's gonna die, and that's gonna be it after all this. Each painting and photograph on the wall seems to watch you. The mythos event affects the investigator in a hall, office, or study with the lowest sanity.
You're in a hall. I am in a hall.
Okay, so who's got the lowest sanity?
I am.
Yeah, it would be
crazy.
Well,
I've got with 4 after. 5.
I'm crazy with 4. So
I'm crazy with 5. It's
so,
me.
So it's Vicky, Wendy. Resolve the event. You find yourself captivated by the closest picture on the wall using your observation. Roll your observation. You need to roll observation of 2 to pass.
Okay, and I have the lucky cigarette case, so I get. To change one of those magnifying glasses. Observation is 4.
And you pass.
Woo!
You find yourself staring at a portrait of an elderly version of yourself, or me. Suffer 1 face down horror and become dazed.
Oh my. Thank you. Looking right. Ugly on the crazy scene.
Are you
scene.
Double crazy yet?
Not yet. Yeah. Two more, I'm double, double crazy.
Oh, you mean, yeah.
Then I'm
like
out.
Like that? Yeah. All right. That was the mythos.
Anyone could be double crazy.
So back
it's to Wendy.
Back to our phase. When the scream begins, you believe it to be a human being crying out in fear, but by the time the last echoes die, you can only conclude that in some sort of wild beast, far closer than you would like, each investigator suffers one face down horror.
Oh, great. Thank you. One more and more, I'm done.
Yeah, I know. Where am I at?
Oh.
Where am I at? 2, 4, 6, 8. Who do we appreciate?
One more
One
for
more
you.
For me, too. Oh, brother.
This is face down, right?
Yeah. How many crazies you got?
An unearthly sound shudders the estate, leaving your ears ringing. A violent wind begins tearing through the halls, floors, and the walls splinter apart, debris flying around you. Each investigator suffers 3 damage. Your agility negates it. So we got to roll our agility.
Weird.
My agility of 3. And that's a no, so I negate
See,
1.
Now, I have a problem. She's just as agile as William.
That I know,
seems
right?
a little bit like a stretch.
Oh my goodness.
That
the epic fail goes yeah. to Wendy.
Wow.
Wendy one shot.
Wendy could not do that if she tried.
That's like you jumped to the side and kicked yourself in the back of the head.
Well, she's very agile, so it could happen. and 2 for you. All right. What else? Anything? Oh, another investigator phase. Oh, back to this puzzle, for the love of goodness. All right. I gotta roll my lore. I gotta roll 5. Can I have the dice? All right. 1, and I've got no
These
clues.
These are the worst
I have
rolls
no clues
ever.
Left.
Just so, throw whatever you want in there, because I have no idea even what the answers mean.
I don't
Blue.
Either.
Let's do...
My guess would be that green. Out of 5, you only have to get 4 correct, is what they're showing us.
Yellow, red, the white back there.
Wow.
Holy moly.
The further we get into
Guys,
it, the less
yeah.
I know what's
do
happening.
Do we call it?
Yeah, I think that, yeah. I think that's an unsolvable
well,
puzzle
I think
for us.
Well, let's move our next ones, because I think the house is going to get ripped to shreds on the next. Mm-hmm. What do you think?
I think we're getting...
So, you can move, but that's all you can do, right? So, you can move up to
oh,
where
I can
I'm
actually
at.
Come in
No,
there.
He can come in there and look at the puzzle.
Can you do 2 things? You can only move once.
I can only
right?
move once,
okay.
Yeah.
Well, do you want to have a crack at this puzzle?
I mean, not really.
I know.
I don't understand it. It feels a little like math class.
It does. Well, this went even farther off than we were here. And this stayed the same. Which doesn't even make any sense. Unless it's... Is it 4? Should we only put 4?
See what happens when you do.
Can we look at all of them? Can you scroll down and look at the yes. other guesses we had?
Yes.
Can you go all the way to the beginning? Because I'm okay. Yeah, see that?
We're at 11 guesses. I think we call it.
I think so. I think we've run out of the house.
I don't
we go get a
the
beer.
Puzzle.
I know.
We're all nuts.
Defeated by a pattern puzzle at the end of the game. That's pretty sad.
It is.
So, best part about this game is the fact that it changes every time you play it. Mm-hmm. So, from a replayability standpoint, there, you know, it's infinite, you know, mm-hmm. so because we've played this is the 3rd time now, and it's been different every single time. So, there's similar things that pop up, but they happen in different orders, they happen in different rooms. We've introduced rooms here that we haven't in the last few scenarios that we played. So it's pretty cool. And now the frightening thing is, this is the basic scenario. This is the starter scenario that they tell you to
Although,
get started with.
There's probably going to be a million people watching. They're like, duh.
I know,
so
right?
Obvious.
So yell at us in the
How
comments.
How did you not get it?
How do you solve this puzzle? Because for the love of God, we could not figure it out. So,
and all of us college educated.
Yes, yes. But we're crazy. We do have that going for us. We are crazy. So let us know what you think. Please give it a shot. It'll be really curious to hear if you've ever played the original Mansions of Madness minus the app, how you feel that the app was, you know, with interacting in the game. And you guys, thanks for playing.
Thanks for having us.
Watch out for more from us. Lord knows what we'll dress like and play next time.
I can't wait.
Anime cyberpunk style meets skirmish combat in Infinity. Experience 8 high-tech factions and fight to control the human sphere at the Infinity Hub on beastofwar.com. Humanity has been driven from Earth, but now it's time to take it back. Join the Reconquest and fight the Scourge on the Drop Zone Commander Hub at beastofwar.com.